Hello friends, my name is Vivek Kulkarni. I welcome you to the first edition of Smart School Hackathon. Let me walk you through why we actually come up with this idea of Smart School Hackathon, and especially why for the students studying in 7th, 8th and 9th standards. Let me go back a little bit in the past and try explaining what the philosophy is, what we expect from this event and so on. In 2015, at Persistent Systems and I4C, we come together to have a first hackathon for engineering college students. So we picked up almost 65 colleges in and around Pune, and we did a idea competitions where the problem statements were drafted by the smart cell, smart city cell for Pune Municipal Corporation. And there were so many good problems that they given. They were about security, they were about waste management, then they were about the public transport and so on. And we set the model of hackathons for engineering college students, where we did a 36-hour non-stop software coding competition. And we got a good response from all these students. They really come back with a feedback saying that they learned a lot by doing, by actually working on these realistic problems and making these products. There are many such ideas which we further incubated, which got actually deployed at various departments for Pune Municipal Corporation, and they've been in use so far as well, be it about waste management or public transport. After establishing that model of hackathons for software, we also have taken that model to AICT. AICT stands for All India Council for Technology Education, that is Government India, that comes under Ministry of HRD, and we approach them that this is a model that we establish by having a Pune Digital Hackathon. Can we take it to the next level? And so they really actually showed interest and help us overwhelmingly by taking this model to the national level. Essentially, what it means is in 2017. We did our first Smart India Hackathon with almost 2,200 engineering colleges across India, where the problem statements were drafted by all the union ministries. The real problems that they are facing were drafted, and students got to learn a lot by actually working on those ideas. There were a lot of industry folks been also showed interest to mentor these students. There were a lot many judges coming out of industry as well. And this whole public-private kind of a relationship model been established, and that's so far as the world's most, I would say by statistics wise, I mean, like we have 2,200 colleges participated for the first time. There are almost 45,000 students submitted their ideas for solving those problems. Almost 28 ministries who have given the problem statement. The competition actually was held in almost 26 plus states in India. Eventually, we actually made it a routine. So, in 2018, we also established another angle to it and called it as hardware hackathon, not just about software problems, but also working on the hardware specific problems. In the subsequent year, which is the current year 2019, we also have incorporated almost 100 plus industries to give the problem statements. Now, there are a lot of union ministries, state governments, there are private organizations giving the real problems that they want to solve. And there are almost 2.5 lakh students who participated in the last edition. And we already into the fourth edition, where we aiming at almost participation from 5 lakh plus students across India. While we are doing that, we thought that this is a good model where it's more of a win-win for everyone, like all ministries, state government, private organization. They're actually getting the POCs, the proof of concepts for various problems been done in just a prize money of 1 lakh rupees, which they offer to the winning team. At the same time, the same problem can be actually solved by multiple teams looking at various aspects of it, or maybe various ways of implementing it. Okay. So that's the experimentation is happening in just, and of course, it's not just about saving the money or the cost for the problem statement owner, but it also means that the students are actually got to learn by working on the real problem in the world. Okay, the same time, there are a lot of evaluators and mentors from industry are helping. Almost 2000 plus people from industry are helping at various level as mentors, as evaluators, as judges and so on. And this model has actually been established very correctly for students, and it's benefiting almost all the parties involved therein. We thought, why not actually experiment that further? Because say engineering students, actually they are the students who actually go beyond 12th standard and they have started working towards their curriculum to make into industry, either as entrepreneurs or as seeking a job in the industry. So that model actually works for them very well. And almost from the first year engineering to PhD, I mean, most of the students are covered therein because the participation shows that. There are a lot many private organizations, private universities, there are various national level organizations like IITs, NITs, they took part, and this platform really is helping all of them. Now the thought process was, can we do something before 12th, or rather for the students who are actually studying in undergoing the higher education in schools. Now with that thought, we actually tried looking at various students in various schools, and we identified that various schools already have that infrastructure of tinkering labs, be it robotic labs, there are software labs, there are design labs, there are so many things that these schools already provide as facilities to the students. And even if there are many schools who doesn't have those facilities, but students are so aware, or rather so much aware nowadays, that they can even do much better than engineering students. Now said that, is engineering is the only domain they look forward to? No. So what is the intent of having this school hackathons? Why actually having to solve those problems, and what they are going to learn? Are this all school students are going to be engineers? May not be. There are few might go in science stream, few might go for arts, few might go to commerce. There may be in other streams, one may require our help. They actually have liking for astronomy and astrophysics and so many things. What we thought is, at least start with the problem statements which these students face every day in their life. Okay. So if you look at the problem statement that we have selected for you, are very much from your domain. Okay. So be it that there is a book which is missing in the bag that I carry to the school every day. If I go to get a notification that this book is required today, I think I would save a lot of time and headache while I am going to the school. Same way, there are many schools that we observe that doesn't have a clean toilet. Can that be automated? I mean, of course, the cleaning staff or the facility staff is there, but how long? I mean, we will be relying on the manual efforts. Can this be automated based on the requirement? What about the noise level? Typically, I mean, we observe that at various off lectures, when the teacher is missing or probably has to take a leave from the school due to some scenario at home otherwise, can the noise level in the classroom be actually at least alerted to the students or the staff around, so that they can actually control the situation? So there is a noise detection kind of an algorithm we expect you to build. Of course, when I say algorithm, it's not always about software, it's about using the right sensors, right algorithms, right hardware, right philosophy, right thought process. And programming is not just about software or hardware, it's about how you approach a problem as well. So it's not just restricted. We are not looking at students as if they are going to be the next engineers. We are looking at a student as if they are a good problem solver. And I think problem solving is required by any domain and every domain out there. So essentially, if you look through, there are other two problems which are more societal problems, essentially, like saving water. Okay. And saving water only starts if you have the awareness how much is getting wasted. Okay. So there is this kind of a problem. We also wanted to draft many such problems about traffic rules, or there is typically a congestion being observed outside schools, and there are so many other problems as well that we observe. We have restricted this first edition to those 5 problems. We have restricted this to only those schools who showed interest in the first go, because we want to do this as a pilot round, as we did Pune Digital Hackathon in 2015. We want to establish a model first to see how these students react, how they compete, what competency level these students have. Are they eager to solve these problems which they face every day? And that's the reason we also have put this format into a team, because most of the competitions at the school level, be it Olympiad, be it drawing competition, be it otherwise, or music competition, they are all solo competitions. We want to see how students perform in groups as team. Okay. Because nowadays, I think the students are much more intelligent. They're having high IQ. But at the same time, there is a complaint that the EQ, that is emotional quotient, is going lower and lower. Can we actually work in as a team? Can we use each other's strengths and build something, approach a problem in some different unique way and win the competition? So winning a competition has to be a side effect, but can I actually give my full 100% ability as a team to this, solving this problem, is what we are looking forward to. So I think this the idea has already been submitted by you, and the scrutiny has been done, the result is out as well. We are now looking forward to the finale, which is happening on the 18th of Jan. It is a day long event, almost 12 hours we will be engaging you. There will be few modifications, because we know that you already have submitted the proof of concept prototypes and even videos, how you attack the problem, how you solve the problem. We further want to give you some small requirements, and we want to observe you, how you actually respond to that change as a team during those 8 hours and come up with a nice solution and let the best team win. But at the same time, those who already been shortlisted, those who already been participated in the first ever school hackathon, I think they are all the winners, because they firstly adopted to be a team, they adopted to solving those problems, they accepted the problems, and they are trying to attempt and learning problem solving by actually working on the realistic problem. I think that's what really matters at the end. Okay, so problem solving is a skill, and that you need to adopt irrespective of which stream of education which you go into later after your schooling is over. And primarily we have taken only 7th, 8th and 9th standard student, because for reasons, when 10th, 11th and 12th is more towards exam oriented study that people get into, and everybody is so overwhelmed in their studies that we don't want to disturb them as well. If I go below 7th standard, I think people are still learning and just new to higher education. So we want to engage this class 7, 8 and 9 student to really perform well, see how they actually solve these problems. So we are looking forward to the solutions and the team culture that we are going to observe you for on 18th of Jan. So all the best to all the teams, let the best team win, let everyone learn something out of this along with us, whether we can establish this model. We also have plans to take this further. So if there are really good ideas that come through this exercise, we really want to incubate those two or three ideas with the help of Atal Incubation Mission. So we already are talking to Government of India, Niti Aayog, for this. We really want to take this again to the next step at national level, maybe to begin with, maybe to the state level and then to the national level. But we really want to make it big, like what we did for Smart India Hackathon earlier. So let's see how it goes, and all the best to all of you. Thank you.